When you identify a malicious IP or URL on your network from a user-reported phishing attack, it's critical to determine, when did this attack first occur? Is the attack ongoing? How many times have malicious observables been recorded in the logs? Which users or devices have connected to the IP or URL? And finally, did any security compromise occur? When you identify such observables within a security incident, you can use the Sightings search capability to search for them in your log store. In this example, a URL in a user-reported phishing email is found to be malicious. We can search for recipients of the suspect email and interactions with the URL by accessing Investigation in the Explore tab and selecting a search type under Search Criteria. Email search allows us to search the mail server for the presence of the email in users' mailboxes, or we can select Log Store to search for recipients of the email within a given time frame of the email gateway logs. We enter the first few letters of each field, and the system provides a list of matching observables from the incident record. The message ID field is optional. We select the time frame and run the search. And here's our results. The email search shows the users that received the phishing email within that time window. Now let's perform an observable sighting search to find out how many users clicked the malicious URL that was in the phishing mail. We see the number of sightings, which is the count of users who have clicked the URL, and get the details in the affected users list. The phished user field displays whether or not the user received the email, and user interaction shows us whether or not they clicked the link. Several scenarios are possible here. If both column values are true, the user received the email and clicked the link. If the column values are true, false, the user received the email but did not click the link. If the column values are false, true, the user didn't receive the email directly but somehow clicked on the link. This leads to the possibility of the URL being part of a larger phishing campaign with varied send email addresses and email subject lines. For each user who clicked the link, you'll want to create a child security incident. All of these child security incidents are pinned to the original incident. These new incidents appear here. Notice that the user is in the subject line of each incident, making it unique. Now you can further investigate each child security incident to see if any malware was downloaded or any other security compromise occurred for any of those users. For more information, please see our product documentation, knowledge base, or podcast, or ask a question in the ServiceNow community.